I want to welcome everyone today and invite you to share my journey in creating a dream of mine, a baseball training facility to help area youth learn the great game of baseball and to help instill core values like work ethic, commitment, and teamwork. My name is Cody Darcy, and I'm the owner and operator of Central Coast Baseball Academy in San Luis Obispo, California. Baseball has always been my passion, and I've known for a long time my ultimate goal was to stay connected to the sport I love for as long as possible, whether this was playing myself or passing my knowledge along to area youth. A year ago, I was playing my last season of Division I baseball and trying to map out how I could make my dream of running a baseball training facility a reality. As with any new venture, the road has had its ups and downs, but I'm excited to share with you how the skills I learned on critical thinking have helped me through various challenges I have faced thus far in my journey. In one of my final college courses, I was asked the question, how exactly do we get better at problem solving, decision making, and creativity? Of course, my first reaction was to say, well, we just need to practice it. The more experience I have at making decisions and being creative, the better my problem solving will be. The professor in my course then mentioned the concept of critical thinking, and the more we discussed the concept, this light bulb in my head clicked, and I found a valuable tool that didn't cost any money or wasn't a fancy gadget. It was a framework that I could use at any time, especially when the decision or problem I faced would have a big effect on my final outcome. We have all experienced a challenge or problem and have been asked, hey, did you think through before you made that decision? And in most cases, especially with simple or unimportant decisions, we go to our automatic thinking. We use our past decisions, experiences, or the first idea that comes into our mind as the solution. Critical thinking can be described as analytical, thoughtful, questioning, probing, non-emotional, organized, innovative, Socratic, logical, methodical, examining, thinking outside the box, and scientific. But my favorite descriptor is purposeful. When we are purposeful and we think about our thinking, we are able to look at issues differently, develop a clear understanding of problems or situations, make faster and more accurate conclusions and quality decisions, avoid making mistakes or reaching dead ends. It is important to remember that critical thinking is a purposeful method of enhancing our thoughts beyond just our automatic, everyday way of thinking. It's a process that uses a framework and tool set that increases clarity and solutions. The benefits of critical thinking result from changing the way we look at issues, organize our thoughts, and incorporates other ideas. It stimulates new perspective and prevents distorted views of a situation, resulting in better problem solving and decision making. So how did thinking about my thinking help me build a baseball training facility? Well, I'm excited to share four different critical thinking strategies I incorporated when faced with four very distinct challenges. The first critical thinking strategy I utilized is actually one used a lot by educators. It is called Understanding by Design, or UBD for short. Now, of course, I had to tweak it a little because I'm not using it to plan a math lesson. I needed to use it to build a baseball facility. The underlying premise of UBD is that we determine our end result and work our way backward. In many situations, our automatic thinking starts us at the process and procedures, and then we get a result at the end. UBD is different. The UBD process is organized into three stages. 1. Identify desired results. I always had a vision in my head of what my perfect baseball training facility was going to look like. I know I spent hours imagining and designing the space in my head. Using UBD, I was forced to purposefully think about what my true desired results were. Not just keeping them in my head, but putting them down on paper with as much detail and clarity as possible. 2, determine acceptable evidence of success. I then needed to decide on what specific evidence would be needed for each of my desired results. What were some tangible tasks or projects that when completed would show my success in achieving the desired results? With my master list of evidence done, the third step was to create the tasks needed to show the evidence of success. In this step, I'm fine-tuning and planning out the procedures and steps needed to accomplish my evidence. By utilizing the UBD concept, I was able to gain more clarity on what I was really trying to achieve in regards to my facility. Spending time getting clear on what I was trying to achieve at the beginning of my journey will save me tremendous amounts of time and effort later on, because it minimizes the possibility of having to go back and start again, because I was unclear on my goals and expectations. With my ideas down on paper and a plan in place, there's now time to act on that plan and get the ball rolling. One of the very first obstacles I face, and I am still working to optimize, is space planning and design. The San Luis Obispo area is a highly competitive market for building space and raw land. Purchasing property to build a baseball training facility will cost approximately $1.5 million for the land, with no improvements included. A building and field space must then also be built. As a college kid with a startup program and limited financial funding, this option, although ideal, is something that needs to be planned for, not something that can happen right away. So the most feasible option for me was to lease a pre-existing space. Now you can imagine if land is expensive, warehouse space is expensive as well. Luckily for me, I was able to find a small warehouse space that was in my allotted building budget, but I'm now faced with designing the space so that I can get the most use in the limited space I have. I must also think critically about the design so that as Central Coast Baseball Academy grows, I can move into a bigger space with as minimal additional costs as possible. Here's where another critical thinking strategy was really helpful. The strategy is called emptying your bucket. This critical thinking strategy is used to clear your head of preconceived ideas, past experiences, or initial reactions. Of course, I wanted this grand facility, but could only afford a small space. I had to empty my bucket of prior experiences, negative thoughts, and other preconceived barriers so that I could think critically and creatively about my space. It was important for me to realize that innovative solutions require open minds. Empty buckets and the belief that is a satisfactory solution does exist. We just have to work to find it. By emptying my bucket, I was able to design a netting system that protects the outer walls and door of the facility while also providing two full batting cages that can easily be flattened so that the space can also be converted into a turf infield. Increase the lighting for hitters by installing new lighting. Utilize the natural sunlight in California by attaching the netting system so that the garage-style doors of the facility can be open, allowing light to enter the facility. And finding a darker wall paint to increase the contrast with the baseball, while also making sure not to darken the space. Here is a quick clip showing the transformation of the space from beginning to our current stage. As always, the project is never ending, but I'm excited about the results so far. Fire, getting stronger. This is how legends are made. Above it all, untouchable. Facing is the training of new employees so that my brand and expectations are consistent across all teams and employees of Central Coast Baseball Academy. It was exciting to know that even without a finished facility, I was able to field three baseball teams between the 10U and 13U levels and provide private training to about 30 players. With this growth, I'm not able to do all the instruction on my own. I needed to hire two additional coaches and am now faced with implementing a strong training program that gives them the flexibility to utilize their strengths in coaching, but that also provides the guidelines and expectations of my business and brand. To help me work through this situation, I am implementing the critical thinking strategy titled So What. So What gets to the relevance, the importance, the value, and the impact of the situation. Making sure that my new employees understand the reasoning behind the expectations will help them create buy-in and motivate to adhere to the core values of our program and to feel ownership so that they feel comfortable contributing to their ideas and suggestions. Although I'm still working on this challenge, my goal is to look for specific steps of the process and procedures I feel are crucial and find the so what behind them. So what questions I can incorporate to find clarity include: why is this process or procedure there? What is important? What is the outcome? What is the consequence of complying or not complying with the process? Are people following the process or procedures? If not, so what? What are the consequences for non-compliance? By thinking through these questions, I can provide worthwhile training experiences and will be able to make sure that the expectations are reviewed and reflected upon consistently. These steps will help make sure our core values are lasting and viewed as important. By this point, I'm sure you're beginning to understand how critical thinking can improve problem solving and decision making. But I want to share one more challenge and the critical thinking strategy I feel will help me work through this situation. As a facility manager, one of the most critical components of our job is the care and operation of our equipment and assets. All of the assets at Central Coast Baseball Academy are brand new now, but over time will need replacement. Saving and budgeting so that I can eventually afford a bigger space means being proactive in caring for and minimizing damage or replacement costs, especially on highly used and expensive pieces of equipment. Take, for instance, the Hack Attack pitching machines. These pitching machines cost approximately $10,000 each and have a lifespan of about 5 years, depending on actual usage. The warranty covers 1 year. For this reason, I must establish a consistent maintenance plan that includes care, depreciation slash repair costs, and a maintenance schedule so I can get the most out of my equipment for as long as possible. The critical thinking strategy I will incorporate to help tackle this challenge is called anticipatory thinking. Anticipatory thinking is a cognitive process by which we recognize challenges and problems that may arise and prepare to face them. It is a mental mechanism that allows us to formulate possible alternatives with a view of the future and make sense of them before they occur. As I begin to use this strategy, I must ask myself, what's next? Or what consequences might this action cause? This way of thinking will help me create an asset list. Decide which asset needs to be included in the preventative maintenance plan. Identify necessary preventative maintenance tasks. Create a maintenance schedule. Establish a training program and maintenance handbook. And monitor and adjust the maintenance plan as needed. I know as my facility grows, I will continue to face challenges and will be forced to think critically about how I can find the best possible conclusion to act upon. It isn't always easy, but thinking critically in the beginning will ultimately provide better and faster results in the long run. I would like to leave you with a quote by Albert Einstein that when faced with a particularly difficult challenge, inspires me to purposefully and critically think about how I can solve the situation. Albert Einstein once said, "We can't solve problems by using the same kind of thinking we used when we created them." Thank you for listening to how critical thinking has been applied to my baseball facility journey.